The PortSec project started from a local captain of the port coming to us and saying, I have all these people asking me to buy their equipment, and they have no way of demonstrating how their equipment is going to lower the risk to the port. We applied traditional risk analysis tools and models to model the risk that a port faces from a variety of threats and vulnerabilities. What strategic infrastructure is located within the port that would make a target for a terrorist? We identified those and gave each of them an identifier that we can then use to calculate what is the threat from a terrorist attack to that location, what is the vulnerability of that location to an attack, and what are the consequences if an attack is successful at that location. If you take those three variables, you get what is known as risk.
Well, this is the port security software. The central region here is an actual map of the port of LA and Long Beach complex. The regions here that are colored represent regions of interest, and the colors represent the assessed risk. And the idea here is that you have resources available over here that you can allocate to some of those red colored regions in order to reduce the risk. So if, for example, Terminal A, which is right here, we can move squad cars, because we have some spare squad cars over, and notice the color of the region is changing from red to yellow to green, indicating that by increasing the security countermeasures, we reduce the assessed risk of an attack. The multicolored bar represents the future. And these numbers represent hours into the future. And what's really interesting about some of the data sources that we have is that they can anticipate what the vessel calls are in the future, for example. And so you can anticipate what your resource needs are in order to reduce risk at certain parts of the port. For example, if you click on number 5 here, which is 5 hours into the future, you notice how red everything became, which means we're going to need to do some resource allocation to reduce that risk.
We would load this software on their computers, bring that software directly into their control rooms. They can look at that monitor and say, all right, here are the risk areas. Here's where there's higher risk, lower risk, and I can move my resources around to minimize the overall impact of the port.